Welcome back, everyone, to another incredible episode of Chat with Dan. For today, we have the incredible Lexi on the show. You already know her. She's incredible. For today, we basically watch a couple of trailers, have fun. Hope you like this episode. Now, some of these trailers, the movies have been already released. So let me know what you think in the comments, and I'll see you in the next one. Enjoy the show. Welcome back. It's amazing. It's a pleasure. It's a delight. I mean, what can I say? I mean, it's epic to have you back here, basically.
So good to be back. Thanks for having me.
I love it. Like, what has been, like, the third time?
I think so, yeah.
Yeah. I mean, you're basically a regular here, which I love.
I love
Fantastic.
It too.
Fantastic. So, for today, we basically will be watching some trailers here, react to them, have fun, and that's it.
Great.
All right, so let's start with the first one. Here we go.
That is but a taste of our fury. Do you yield?
I do not. I finally found it. Now who's gonna stop me?
That one's perfectly fine.
Come on, Mario!
Mushroom Kingdom, here we come!
Thoughts on this one?
Here we go. Oh, man. It's so funny because it's really weird to, like, give Mario a personality. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like, when you mm-hmm. played with Mario when you were a kid, it's just, like, this little, you know, it's almost like Pac-Man, right? Like, he doesn't...
he doesn't talk.
Yeah, and so it's almost bizarre, like, seeing him talk. Because even the video games now, like, you know, they're it's more animated. But, so that was a little jarring. Also, the first scene, the like battle between the dragon, I'm trying to remember what the character's name is, the Dragon King or whatever. But it's very Game of Thrones-esque. Like there's a lot of like, I don't know, did you watch Game of Thrones?
Yeah.
Yeah. So there's a lot of like the overhead shots and stuff of like the army kind of outside of the castle or whatever. Like that exact shot was in some episodes of Game of Thrones with like Daenerys's army. So it's fun to see like the different like pop culture references. But I'm trying to remember when this movie was first announced, wasn't there all this controversy about the cast?
Yeah. What ended up happening is the people got, I mean, angry, like literally angry because let me show you, because they were putting like Chris Pratt to be like the voice of Mario. And as we were saying, like the fact that for the games, Mario doesn't really talk, you know, and there was like a French version of the trailer in which it looks like more precise as the original Mario voice, let's say.
Right.
And so a lot of people was like arguing about it. But when I saw like the whole reaction to it, I was like, you know, I played Mario too, but I was like, I mean, it looks good. And, you know, also Chris Pratt, I mean, I love all of his work. I mean, he's super talented and super funny. So yeah. why not give him a shot, you know? I mean,
yeah. I think it was partially because he's not Italian. And yeah. They were like, yeah, he should be Italian. And I definitely get that. I mean, they're especially with all of the whitewashing of casting for the last 100 years in Hollywood, totally. I understand the pushback on that. But then it's like, well, Italian is still Caucasian and Chris Pratt is Caucasian. You know, it's like, so I don't know who people wanted to be cast, if they wanted like someone from Italy or an Italian American actor.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, every celebrity is going to go through their drama, and he has definitely gotten a lot of flack over the years. But I loved him in Parks and Rec, and I loved him in Guardians of the Galaxy. So certainly don't have anything against him. It's quite the cast though. I'm trying to figure out like who Fred Armisen is playing.
So we got Chris Pratt, Anna Taylor-Joy, Charlie Day, Jack Black, Keegan Michelle. I mean, it's Seth Rogen. I mean, come on. It's super cool.
I don't know Sebastian Maniscalco. I don't recognize that name, but I mean, this is just a dream job for actors, getting to like go in and do the voices of characters like this. It's got to be so fun.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I do agree. I was checking also that some people were arguing like why they didn't use like the original guy who did all the, you know, like all of the very small like reactions, like hey, who, you know, like all of the jumping and things like that. That why they didn't use him. So I think that's what caused like the whole polemic, because like the whole problems, because they weren't like using the guy who has played that for, I think, for over 20, 30 years, something like
right,
that.
Right, yeah.
But
those efforts in voiceover, the like effort sounds, like the
mm-hmm. Yeah, yeah. So yeah, that is why a lot of people were like not happy about it. And as I said, if you watch like the French trailer, it sounds like more, apparently, yeah, it sounds like more like Mario. So that's why some people say, like, why you didn't put somebody else instead of Chris Pratt, who is like. But at the same time, I mean, like the few small phrases that we managed to hear, I mean, they sound pretty good. So.
Yeah. Well, I mean, his agents are good because he's in a lot of these movies. He's also the voice of the Lego movie guy.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah, true.
Lego movie. Yeah. So. Yeah, I mean, it would have been interesting to see somebody else, but I'm not up in arms about the casting. I love Jack Black, Charlie Day. I mean, there's some good people in this cast. So,
yeah.
It'd be fun to see.
Yeah, absolutely. I can agree. I mean, I prefer like to watch it first, and after I watch it, then I can say, okay, yeah, it makes sense. You know, because I think sometimes for a trailer, whenever you like, I mean, I wouldn't say like criticize, but for example, on this case, that with the voice of Chris Pratt, I was like, come on, it's a trailer. I mean, we need to wait for the movie so we can all see it. And then we can say like, okay, probably wasn't, you know, probably wasn't like good enough or things like that. But at least I do think that, I mean, with this cast, that this film is in good hands. So we'll see.
Yeah. Also, I'm glad that the trailer didn't give too much away. Like totally. It showed the world a little bit, but it, you know, trailers these days can oftentimes give away the whole story. So,
there's a lot.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. There's, have you saw the trailer from Terminator? I think it was Judgment Day.
I don't think so.
I mean, there was a trailer from Terminator films, like the most recent ones, that actually the trailer revealed the whole film. That there was actually some people would say that if you don't want to watch the film, watch the trailer, because it literally shows everything. You know, so that's crazy. So yeah. But anyway, so the next question would be, would you watch this on theaters, on an airplane, or on your phone or iPad, let's say?
This is one I would probably watch either at home or on an airplane. I fly a lot, so
oh, yeah.
So it's pretty common that I could watch something on the airplane. But yeah, either, you know, on my TV or my laptop at home, or I probably, this is not one that would definitely get me into the theaters. And I have to say, I love going to the theater, but I'm going a lot less since the pandemic, you know,
Yeah,
everything.
absolutely. Plus, you're traveling basically all the time, so
Yeah.
yeah.
But it's, I've been, luckily I've been able to go to some SAG screenings recently because this year they do a random lottery for who gets to vote for the SAG awards every year. So I'm on the SAG nominating committee this year.
Cool.
And it's been really cool. And I've like invited to all these screenings and Q&As and everything. But I didn't realize when I like said yes to doing it that like it's a lot of work. Like I have to
I bet.
watch tons of movies and like they've probably sent me over 50 DVDs like in the last month that I'm supposed to watch by January 8th. And I was like, oh my God, what did I get
That's
myself?
crazy. Wow. Okay. Yeah, that's a lot.
So, but I won't be seeing most of them. And I did the screenings that I've gone to, it's been nice to go see things in the theaters, but
Yeah.
most of them I just have to watch at home because who
Yeah, it's
has the
crazy.
time?
Wow, 50. Wow, okay. Okay, yeah, I can agree on that. Yeah. All right. Next one, you ready?
Yeah.
Perfect. So, by the way, they also have Luigi, so I love that too. Right, next one.
Katie, you lost your parents.
Welcome home.
You're my niece. I'm gonna do everything I can to make this place feel like home.
Just wish I could see them again.
I'm not equipped to handle this. I don't even take care of my own plants. I have this project at work. Do you want to see?
Yes.
Ever since I was little, I dreamed of this perfect toy that would protect a kid from ever feeling lonely or sad. This is Megan.
Hi, Megan. I'm Katie. It's nice to meet you, Katie. Do you want to hang out? Okay.
Megan, your goal is to protect Katie from harm, both physical and emotional.
Is that a doll?
Model 3 generative. Android. Megan, for short.
I can't believe you made this. I love it. Wanna hang out? Yeah, sounds like fun. Great job.
It's nice to have a friend. It's honestly like she's part of the family now.
They could be building emotional connections that are too hard to untangle.
She's the happiest she's been since her parents died. Eat the toppings, Katie.
Research shows if you force a child to eat vegetables, they'll be less likely to choose those foods as adults.
Is that so?
Yes. Experts say.
Megan, turn off.
I thought we were having a conversation.
Does she talk? Make her say something.
Stop! Don't! Megan! You should probably run. Megan, she pushed Brandon onto the road. I won't let anything harm you.
Megan, turn off.
Recalibrating response model. Megan! What's wrong with you? Don't worry, Katie. I won't let anything harm you. Ever again. It's nice to have
thoughts.
Whoa. that one is like Big Hero 6. Did you see that movie? It's like Big Hero 6 meets Ex Machina meets
Annabelle.
It's that's creepy for sure. Or her also came to mind. With oh my gosh, what's his name? I'm blanking on the actor's name. But yeah, it's that dystopian future, you know, robots becoming human kind of thing, but make it horror. It
Yeah.
looks good. I would see it. It's you got to be ready. You got to be in the mood for horror for that one for sure.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah.
Also kind of like Chucky, right? Like this like young.
Yeah, but like on steroids looks like. You know, like really, yeah. And you know, what I enjoy about this trailer is the fact that it's something that it could happen, you know, that we had like this robot, and then it just because of a malfunction goes rogue, and then starts into this killing spree or something. I mean, perhaps like right. nothing that could happen, but at least that perhaps would like it could harm someone, you know, like things like that, you know. Because, for example, when I saw this trailer, they were telling me this story about that. So they gave someone an Alexa, you know, and then suddenly they were hearing in the other room where it was Alexa starting like to speak like this language. And then when they went, they're like, Alexa, what are you doing? Oh, I'm learning. And that was like super creepy. I'm like, oh, so they ended up like, you know, like turn it off. And I was like, that could happen at some point, you know, an AI malfunction could happen. So.
Yeah. And also that robots don't understand, or not yet, understand subtlety. So, or like nuance.
Yeah.
So like, because everything's black and white, it's like, I am created to protect you. So I will protect you, even if that means hurting someone else, you know?
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. You could imagine that you throw like a joke at someone, and then the AI to take it as a threat, and they ended up like hurting you. Like, you were almost doing like a joke or thing like that. Yeah. 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 I do. I would definitely be watching this as well, because it looks interesting. Plus like the whole, you know, like the whole like dancing on like on still like and having like a still face, that's super creepy.
I wonder how they filmed that. I'm wondering if there is an actress who played the robot, and then they either put some kind of mask on her, or like CGI.
Yeah. They're like that.
What's wrong with you?
That.
Don't worry, Katie. I won't let anything harm you.
Yeah, I'm super sure that that is someone playing that, and they just perhaps like CGI some stuff, and the voice probably, you know, they ended up like making it sound like an AI. So yeah,
looks cool.
So yeah, I'll be definitely watching that. So, right. And also, this actress, she was also in the film Get Out, right?
Yes. She first got famous in the show Girls.
Mm-hmm.
And she's also the daughter of a pretty famous newscaster.
Okay.
So that in New York City. So that's how she kind of came to fame. What's her name? Allison something. Mm-hmm. But yeah, she was in Get Out. Yeah. So she does
horror
good
films.
With that sort of like tone of movie, that creepy.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, we'll see what. Well, that ended up, but actually, yeah, it looks cool. So yeah, we'll have to see then.
Yeah.
Oh, crap. All right, so next one, you ready?
Yeah.
Here we go.
You ain't driving, are you?
I steer a little, but the reindeer do most of the work.
This is my fourth year as a Santa. How about you?
I started the whole damn thing.
Christmas!
We decided that you could have one gift.
Early.
What is it?
That is a direct hotline to Santa Claus himself.
I can talk to Santa.
All right, revelers. Welcome to your worst Christmas ever.
Let's go!
You have $300 million in your personal vault. That's what I want for Christmas.
I don't want any trouble, okay?
Something's gonna scooch up that chimney.
Who is he?
Because it's not your typical mall Santa.
Santa, are you there? Daddy said you were very busy tonight. My name is Trudy Lightstone.
Are you gonna help us, Santa?
Yeah, Trudy.
Santa?
No, my nice list.
Santa Claus is coming to town. Time for some season's beatings.
Who the hell are you?
Boss, what if he really is the
There's
real?
No
such thing as Santa.
Yeah! These bad men, they're all on my naughty list. Naughty.
That's naughty!
And what do you do to the naughty ones?
I give them a lump of coal.
Where is it?
I gotta watch.
Ah! I believe in you, Santa.
Come on. Which one of you did that? Prancer? So unprofessional.
All right, thoughts on this one?
Oh, hilarious. David Harbour as Santa. It's like Santa Claus action movie. I feel like the last one we had of those was Die Hard, and there definitely wasn't Santa Claus in that. Santa. Mm-hmm. I feel like that's what they're trying to do is recreate, like, you know, what's what are the quotes from Die Hard? Like, yippee-ki-yay, motherfucker, and, like, you know, that Merry Christmas. So, like, I forget what it is. His lines, I will say the trailer is giving away too many of the good lines in the movie, because, like, all of these, like, what did he say at the end? I can't remember. I was trying to I should write them down as they're coming on. But he had a lot of good, like, funny one-liners. That it's not a kids movie, that's for sure.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. It's cool. Yeah. And also, you know, that it's, at least to me, it's kind of a refresh Christmas film, you know? Because normally, like, on this type of year, we will get, like, a lot of Christmas movies, which basically, I mean, they're like, you know, they're touching kind of the same topics, family, love, you know, all of that type of stuff, which is cool. But now with this one, it's like, as you mentioned, and I do agree on that they're actually kind of trying to, like, recreate the action with Christmas, which I think is pretty cool. Yeah.
But you're right, it is, it's something we haven't seen in a little while. Like, someone was just like, what if Santa was actually a badass?
Actually. And no martial arts and things like that.
Yeah. We always see him as, like, you know, kind of fat and lazy, and, like, except for this one night when he flies around the world. And so it is kind of funny to, like, you know, see
him drinking and
it's kind of like the Liam Neeson of, like, action movie of Christmas movies.
Yeah, or like the John Wick of Christmas films.
Yeah,
it's pretty cool. Yeah, I will definitely be watching that film as soon as it gets in theaters. I will be definitely watching, yeah, because as I said, I mean, I do love action films, and with Christmas on it, that's my jam. So let's see.
Yeah, I would definitely go see this in theaters just because it's fun, right? Like, it's just like, you know, like a good date night movie kind of thing.
Yeah, totally agree on that. Yes. All right, next one. All right, so for this one, yeah, this one is from Black Panther, so I'm gonna just skip it because, you know, the film is it's already, you know, played and everything.
Yeah, it's out already.
So let me just.
One of the screeners I actually got in the mail.
Oh, really? All right, next one.
Hey, everyone. We're extremely sad to have missed D23, but we've been working very hard on the next Deadpool film for a good long while now.
I've had to really search my soul on this one.
His first appearance in the MCU obviously needs to feel special. We need to stay true to the character, find new depth, new motivation, new meaning.
Every Deadpool needs to stand out and stand apart. It's been an incredible challenge that has forced me to reach down deep inside.
And I have nothing. Completely empty up here and terrifying. But we did have one idea. Hey, Hugh, you want to play Wolverine one more time?
Yeah, sure, Ryan.
And I will always love you. I will always love you.
24.
Hi.
Hi. How are you?
You have questions.
Yes. I had a lot of questions. I'm sure you had a lot of questions, but rest assured, we're going to answer them right now. Like, for example, how is Wolverine alive?
Yeah.
After Logan?
Logan takes place in 2029, mm-hmm. totally separate thing. Mm-hmm. Logan died in Logan, not touching that. What actually happens in our film?
I just love Ryan Reynolds so much. It's just fun that they're doing something different. You know what I mean? Like, I've always enjoyed how meta they are in Deadpool. And that they're having fun with it. I mean, it's kind of exciting to really know nothing about it except the fact that Wolverine's going to be in it.
Absolutely. Yeah. Yeah. It's something that everybody has asking for like since the first one came.
Yeah. Yeah. So I'm curious, like, if they have even written it. But
yeah, true.
I'm sure they have. I'm sure they're like at least started filming it. But September 2024, they've got almost 2 years to make it. So that's pretty funny.
Yeah. Yeah, I love it. I love the first one. Love the second one. When I watched Logan, I loved it too. It was super cool. So yeah, I'm excited about it. And also it will be interesting to kind of see them together, you know, because besides like that the fans have wanted that, you can also tell that they have like a very good chemistry, you know, between the two. So I think it's going to be pretty cool. Yeah, I'll be definitely watching.
Remember when the second one came out? How long ago was that?
The second one, 2019. I mean, it was basically kind of a year later after Logan. Logan started.
Okay.
I think like a couple of years later since after Logan. It was 2018, 19.
Yeah, I'm going to look it up. I'm just curious because I'm trying to remember if I even saw the second one. I mean, if I didn't, it wasn't because I didn't want to. I just, you know, forgot. Deadpool 2. Yeah, 2018. Okay. Yeah, mm-hmm. So it's been 4 years. It'll be 6 years by the time it comes out. Interesting. Yeah.
That'll be fun. Yeah, so I'll definitely be watching this. I love it. And I hope that at some point they can get Deadpool and Spider-Man together. That will be awesome too.
Mm-hmm.
That will be awesome.
Yeah.
All right, next one. Here we go.
There's a moment when you say to yourself, it can't be done. But instead of backing down, you push yourself forward. Into the unknown.
Day one shooting, extraction two, we're back.
With a title of two behind your name, you have to bring at least twice the action.
Where the landscape is ever evolving. Where everything that got you here doesn't mean a thing. Unless you can do it bigger and better than ever before.
For extraction one, we had a major action sequence that felt like one continuous shot. We call that a one-er. For extraction two, we're going to push that even further with a sequence more intricate and more extreme than before. And we've got a real helicopter landing on the rooftop of moving trains.
It's pretty damn exciting.
I'm very proud of what we've done.
The end result is going to blow people's minds.
Against all odds. Find a way to make the impossible.
3, 2, 1, fire!
Just another target.
So in this one, we see more like a behind the scenes than the actual trailer. But
I was gonna say it. I was confused if it was like a documentary about the movie or if it was.
Yeah, it looks like they did like a explanation of why the second one is coming. I mean, it looks good. I mean, I would love to be on a set of an action film like that, the explosions and everything. It looks pretty cool.
I didn't see the first one, so I don't really know what to expect. But it is, all of the explosion stuff is fascinating. The closest I've gotten to something like that, I was in I don't even think it was a Miley Cyrus song, but it was like some music video like right out of college, I was like just an extra in this music video, and they crashed cars outside of the parking garage that we were filming on. And it, I mean, it was cool to see, but when I see stuff on this level and like, you know, they're talking about pushing it further and further, it's exciting, but at the same time, it also like, it's so dangerous. Some of the stuff they do and the like stunt performers do and everything. And I just feel like, unfortunately, there are several sad stories on sets of people dying. I mean, and the worst, most recent one is the director that was shot by Alec Baldwin on set. But, you know, I just feel like no one should ever die on a movie set, you know, like it's just, I love what we do. I believe in what we do, but at the same time, like we're just making a movie, you know, like no one needs to die. And there was an awful one, I don't know how many years ago now, but I remember like they were filming on train tracks and like the you know, pre-production kind of dropped the ball and they didn't have the train schedule and like a train was coming and they had to like get out of the way really quickly. And like one of the crew members died because they got hit by the train. Like it was just crazy. So like, it's exciting when I see that kind of stuff, but I'm also like, there's a little bit of like toxic masculinity there where it's like, no, it has to be bigger and better and more. And it's like, no, man, like we can make that happen in CGI now. So like, there's only so much that we need to like do in real life to put the lives of the crew members and the stunt people in danger. So,
yeah,
but it looks exciting.
it looks exciting. That's for sure. But yeah, I mean, now that you mentioned that, imagine like how many films with like really, you know, huge like action scenes and everything that what injuries might happen because of the stunt people, you know, and things like that.
Yeah,
that's crazy.
I think Daniel Radcliffe's stunt double for Harry Potter had was paralyzed on one of the films. And then I also remember hearing that Tom Cruise like was adamant about doing a lot of his own stunts in his last few movies. So like he actually hung from the helicopter and all that kind of stuff. Which is, I mean, if you're trained to do it and you want to do it, but go for it. But it's crazy.
Yeah, actually, there was I think on one of the Mission Impossible when he jumps from the rooftop from a building to another one, that he actually break his ankle and they left the original take. You can actually, if you know like the whole story, like the whole backstory, once you see that scene, you can totally realize that his ankle is broken and he even continued the scene like running, you know, but with it, like that type of stuff, I would say that is pushing to the limit too much, you know. I mean, at the end, I understand that you want to create like, you know, something really amazing, but your body is like the machine that makes it happen. So you need to, you know, take care of it every now and then, you know, and don't try to like push it too much, you know.
Yeah. There's movie magic that can happen.
Yeah, so especially right now with the whole CGI, they can actually do it. Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Now this one, I mean, this one is gonna be on Netflix, so no point. I've been telling you that to see it on theater. So.
Yeah. Although they are doing a lot of like short theatrical releases, because I think some of the rules for being nominated for the Oscars, you have to have a theatrical release. So why some Netflix films are still having like small stints in the theater for that purpose. But they might be changing, or they may have already changed those rules because streaming has become so big now.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, I didn't know that. That's pretty cool. All right, next one. Here we go. Wait, this one is...
Isn't it?
Oh, Hellraiser. Yeah, this one already really happened. Nice. So let me just skip this one.
You can hold it.
Okay.
Wait. There we go. Yep.
Are we gonna sing along?
Yes, of course! I wanna put on.
Thank you.
name's Leonard. Well, it's nice to meet you, Will.
Why are you here?
I suppose I'm here to make friends with you. And your dad's too. But my heart is broken.
Why is it broken?
Because of what I have to do today.
There is a woman carrying something that looks like a pick with a chain and a mallet head.
You see, the four of us have a very important job to do. In fact, it might be the most important job in the history of the world. United by a common vision, which has now become a command that we cannot ignore. The four of us are here to prevent the apocalypse. Your family has been chosen to make a horrible decision. If you fail to choose, the world will end.
Thoughts?
M. Night, I can never pronounce his last name, Shyamalan, always writes such twisted thrillers. I mean, it's a great trailer because I immediately want to know more. Like, I want to know how, what the choices that they have to make, and how did that group of four get formed, and you know, I know that it's going to be a not thriller, but like a suspenseful movie the whole way through. Keeps your heart rate up. but yeah, I mean, I'll definitely see it. And I really enjoy that actor whose the voice is going the whole time. He what's his name? He was
Dave Bautista.
Yeah, he's doing a lot more. I've seen him and like pop up in a lot of movies this year, and he's really great.
Yeah, I can. Yeah, and also the fact that he's right now, I mean, on this film, he's taking like a more serious role, you know, because of the Guardians of the Galaxy, he plays Drax. I mean, it's more like, you know, funny comedy, you know. So right. Here, see him like super serious. But also, one thing that got my attention immediately is this. Let me show you real quick.
Choose decision.
Wait, he is actually Rupert Grint, who plays Ron.
Yeah, I was gonna ask if that was Rupert Grint, because he looks so different in different movies, but he's been acting a lot more too, isn't he? Also, I feel like he was in a TV series recently as well. So it's exciting to see him get back out there.
Yeah, and actually playing like this type of role, you know, because. Yeah. I mean, we already got used to like see him as Harry, like, you know, in the Harry Potter films. Yeah. But now, like, to see him like in a more serious stuff, you know,
yeah.
It looks cool. And it's, and also the fact that they don't say much of it, you know, that it has like a lot of intrigue, and they give you like a small taste of it, but that's it, you know.
Yeah.
It looks pretty cool.
Yeah, a lot of mystery.
Yeah, you know, but at first
the trailer should do. It should just give you a taste.
Yeah. Yeah. You know, at first I thought that it was going to be like a comedy one.
yeah. Because of the music and everything.
Yeah. But then I was like, okay, it's not. So. Right. So.
Which is
yeah, next one.
Honey, maybe we should just call it a night.
You go ahead. I got to finish these centerpieces and rearrange the seating chart.
Yes.
Hello.
Mom, now is not the time.
I just want to ask, is that genetics or is it like Pilates? We got you a gift.
It's your something borrowed.
Brings you good luck, except for Uncle Greg, who ended up decapitated on that forklift. But that's not the knife's fault.
Oh, someone just left that in the bathroom.
You invited your ex? Looks like he's leading a porn safari.
Oops, he forgot to button his shirt all the way up.
Is it time for dinner?
You look so much better than the rest of us.
I think the left boob is slightly lower than the right boob.
Something doesn't feel right.
In the net.
Spray him in the ice. It won't work.
Why?
Too many steps. See, that's why you only have a plan with one step.
Not once did I wonder if I'd be walking handcuffed through the jungle with a live grenade.
Sir, give me the grenade, sir.
You got it!
Are you dead?
We're gonna fix this. That dress is growing on me.
I wanted something less traditional.
Nobody with my family.
Don't let go!
Don't you let go!
Stop shooting her sister!
Carol, thank you for the cake knife. I freaking love this cake knife.
All right, thoughts?
Oh, it's just ridiculous, but fun. I mean, it's giving me a little like Pineapple Express because like they're in the jungle and
okay.
Like, really extreme characters. I'd love to see Jennifer Coolidge getting more action. She's having a moment right now. I mean, it just, this would definitely be like an airplane movie for me, I think.
yeah.
But it looks fun.
Yeah, absolutely. I can agree on that. I mean, I'm not, I mean, that the type of film is not my cup of tea, but we'll see, you know, why not? Why not watch it? Yeah. You know, it looks fun. So
yeah,
we'll see.
Comedy action, you know?
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. Now let's do two more.
Okay.
All right. So next one here.
I've never seen anything like it.
Baby Glade.
What is the president doing in our front yard?
Our entire world is in grave danger. I want you to come with me on an expedition.
I'm not my father. He was the explorer.
I know you were just a kid when he went missing, but now you're all we got.
Mr. Glade, I'm a huge fan.
Oh, thank you.
Of your dad. Do you think you could forge his autograph?
What?
Where in the world are we?
Ethan, you brought the dog?
Sorry!
We are clearly in uncharted territory.
Whoa. Hello, you probably don't understand a word I'm saying.
Of course I understand you.
Huh?
Dad?
Dad?
Grandpa?
I'm a grandpa.
What is this place?
The cliffs are alive, and the waters dissolve the flesh off your bones.
Everything down here is trying to kill us.
Do you mind if I call you Splat? You just kind of give me Splat vibes.
Ow!
I guess I deserve that. Grandpa's awesome!
He is not awesome! You gave me a machete for my birthday?
Classic Jaeger claimed.
I was two.
I'm loving this family reunion, but come on! We got a world to save!
We need you to figure this out, otherwise we're doomed. We are doomed!
Wait, seriously?
No, I'm just messing with you.
Didn't see that coming.
But it's when it's already out, basically.
Yeah, I saw a couple billboards for this, but I hadn't seen a preview yet, so I had no idea what it was about. You know, Disney always finds a way to make me cry by the end of the movie, so I'm sure it'll
You're kidding.
But, but this is, this is definitely a quirkier storyline. I don't know how many alien stories they've done in animation yet, so it'll be fun.
Yeah, yeah. Do you usually, you know, like something interesting is that I do watch like animated ones, but only like with my little cousins, you know, or every now and then I would be like, okay, like the story ones. So, yeah, we'll see about this one.
Yeah, I enjoy animated films. I always like to go see them, and especially Pixar and Disney have made some really touching movies in the past decade. Yeah. So,
yeah, yeah. All right, last one. So here we go.
The roses have faded, there's frost at my door. The birds in the morning don't sing anymore. The grass in the valley is starting to die, and out in the darkness the whippoorwills cry. The darkness is falling, the sky has turned gray, a hound in the distance is starting to bay. Alone and forsaken by fate and by man, oh Lord, if you hear me, please hold my hand. Alone and forsaken by fate and by man.
This is your chance. Hold that shut. You keep her alive. And you set everything right.
And that's it.
Yeah.
So
that's interesting, because that one, I mean, it's a series, first of all, but I really barely understand what the show is going to be about. Like, I get that it's like a dystopian, probably like the, it says The Last of Us. So like the last, you know, people trying to fight for the world, I guess.
Yeah.
But I am excited by, is that Diego Luna?
And no, it's Pedro Pascal, I think.
Oh, right.
Yeah, he played the Mandalorian.
That's right. Mm. Yeah, I'm excited by him and to see his face in a series. And that young actress is from Game of Thrones, and she was amazing in Game of Thrones, so I'm excited to see her.
Really? What?
She played the lady... What's the name of her character? She's like the last of her line up in one of the northern territories, like Starks. She's like the little bear or whatever. And so she's the head of her household, but she's like nine.
Oh, yeah, yeah, right. Yeah. Okay.
She was one of my favorite characters in Game of Thrones. So and that little actress is such a little badass. So yeah, it'll be fun to watch her in something else. And she's a few years older now, so.
Yeah. Actually, yeah, I do. I'm actually kind of excited about this one. Yeah, it looks cool. And also, I played the video game, which is called The Last of Us, basically. So it's basically inspired of that. And actually, some of the scenes that kind of look on the trailer appear on kind of like the game as well. So I'm excited to see like how they ended up, like what can they create, you know? So plus like the whole CGI of the. Of like the whole effects, everything looks super cool. And yeah. I mean, I love Pedro Pascal. I think he's super talented. I mean, he's the man, like he did an amazing job on The Mandalorian. So yeah. Yeah, plus Mandalorian season 3 is coming too soon, I think. So
yeah, and there's another show that I think came out in that universe that I haven't watched yet.
Andor with Diego Luna. Yes. You need to watch it. It's super cool.
That's why I'm confusing them. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I need to watch that first and then get ready for. I know I got behind on all my travel for work this summer. I got behind on TV, so.
Yeah. After what you just told me that you need to watch like around 50 films, probably watch those first and then jump to, you know, some other stuff.
We'll see. They say try to watch as many as you can, so before you vote. So I'm going to do my best.
Absolutely. And I'm sure you're going to be able to make it happen.
Yeah.
Anyway, what I can say, it's amazing to see you again, Lexi. Keep doing an amazing, epic, badass job as you always do. I mean, you're definitely an incredible, super talented person. I love what you do. And also, keep inspiring and good luck with the 50 films. I'm super sure that it's going to be super fun. Make sure to get some snacks and, enjoy it.
Oh, make it fun for sure. Thanks for having me, and it was so good to be here.
Yeah. So I want to thank those who watched this video with us. Thank you so much. Make sure to leave a comment here and there. Let us know. Join the conversation. Let us know what you think, or if you're excited about any other type of, you know, show, film. Also below, it's gonna be Lexi's social media, so you can follow her. As I've been saying, let's make her viral. # Team Lexi, because she's just amazing. And again, Lexi, have an incredible night, and I'll see you in the next one.
Thank you.
All right.
Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to leave a like, subscribe, follow. It helps a lot. And again, thank you so much. Hope you like this episode. Let me know what you think about the films. And I'll see you in the next one. Stay safe.